It's Jerome, welcome back to Dark Souls 2. So last time, you know what I'm going to say? We died. We also arrived here in Majula, which seems to be the new Phylic Shrine. We found a merchant, a blacksmith. Not that we can use that guy yet. And we found some chick that... Oh, and a talking cat as well. Can't forget that. And some chick that allows us to level up at her, because that seems to be the only way we can do it, at least so far. She also gave us our Sunny D Estus Flask, so now we might stand a chance of living just a little bit longer. I mean, we're still going to die horribly all of the time, but we might at least stand a little bit more of a chance. We found the Victor Stone, which is apparently a covenant. Do we have any ore stones? Oh, we need to be in the covenant. Okay, well, screw it, I guess we'll join. This will set you on an arduous path. Yeah, screw it, let's do it. This is probably a really bad idea, but... really? Three warnings? Holy shit. This ain't gonna be a good idea, is it? This is probably either gonna make all enemies tougher. Hey, we've got a champion's tablet. Don't know what it is, we'll check that out in a second. Probably either gonna make the enemies tougher, or maybe it's gonna be a PvP covenant or something. We don't have any ore stones. Didn't think we did, but it was worth a check. Right, what the hell does this tablet say? Shows the names of the greatest victors of the Company of Champions Covenant. Oh, okay, so it does seem to be a PvP covenant. So, I assume, and again, this is just an assumption, but I assume being in that means we're going to get invaded, which is probably a good thing, because right now we haven't been invaded once, and frankly, I feel kind of rejected. Okay, so we got to check down here, and I'll tell you why we got to check down here, because I think this is probably the wrong way to go. Holy shit! Look how many bloodstains! There's literally a trail of bloodstains. This is not good. What the hell? Okay, the contraption doesn't move. I am okay with that. And there's booty in there. Something. No shit. No shit. Right, so there seems to be a gate there, but I don't think that's actually anything. It just seems to be part of the scenery. So anyway, yeah, we're going this direction because I feel like this is probably the wrong way to go. Because there was that pathway near that chick that allows us to level up. I feel like that's probably where we should go because... I don't know, man, it just seems like a safer way than going into like a deep dungeon underground. And all these bloodstains make me feel like I'm right. So I'm going to check this out just in case it is the wrong way to go. Then we know now. So that way we know the other way has to be the way to go. That's my logic, damn it, and I'm sticking to it. Was that a shield? It looked like it had a shield symbol. Yes, it was. Okay, is it good? Well, it's not that bad, and we don't have any, so yeah, screw it. And yes, I know we got the pre-order shields. Again, I don't want to use them, because it feels like cheating to me. It really does, or at least, you know, it's cheap. I don't like that. I like playing the game the way it was intended. And I just found a pull chain, apparently. I didn't even see that. Luckily, the pull option come up. Right. Can we go under here? Can we run... No. This is Dark Souls, you can't roll under things. Right, so that opens this gate. I feel like we're heading into our doom, however, it's a sewer, and, you know... I guess the depths weren't that bad in the first game, as long as you knew about the basilisk buddies that cursed you, so... Maybe we'll get cursed down here, who freaking knows? I'm not even sure curse is a thing in this game, because... If you look at my HP bar, it's gone down a few notches. That's because, as far as I know, every time you die in this game, up to, I think, maybe 10 times, not entirely sure, but, every time you die, you lose a little bit of your maximum HP. I think 50% is the lowest you can go. And then I think the way it works, and again, I may be wrong about this, but I think you have to use a human effigy to restore your HP. So they're kind of like humanity, but they work differently. Kind of more the Demon's Souls style. And again, that's just from what I've heard, because I've never actually played Demon's Souls, but whatever. Gotta say, I'm shocked so far that we've gone through so much of a sewer section and... Wait a minute. We are leaving the sewer, and we're at Heide's Tower of Flame. Apparently there's blood everywhere and a giant dude there. That don't bode well. I assume that's the Tower of Fire there. Anyway, so I was gonna say, it's surprising to me that we went through an entire sewer section and didn't find a single enemy. Is that a good thing? I don't know, but yeah, I get the feeling, considering this is a giant area full of giants, we are probably not supposed to be here yet, but is that gonna stop me? No. No, it's not. We're gonna at least try, but I feel like we're gonna die horribly to one of these guys, but... Hey, you know, whatever. Okay, it seems like auto gun. That was very close. It seems like they've got a free hit combo. I mean, I assume they have other moves, but right now that seems to be all he's doing, which I'm okay with that because it makes him predictable. We aren't doing that much damage, but we have, you know, a third killed him almost half, so. Yeah, oh god. Yeah, they hit. Ouch. Damn it. Gravity man kills me every damn time. Okay, so anyway, yeah. We died, but we didn't die to that guy, so we're gonna go back and try again. If that's a long run, but whatever. Oh, what the hell are you doing here?
Bearer of the curse. Seek souls. Larger, more powerful souls. Seek the king. That is the only way. lest
this land... Okay. She's saying the same damn thing she said before. I thought since she's moved, she might have something new to say, but no. She's just here to taunt me. You bitch. Anyway, I'm gonna run back and I'll see you there. Okay, we have returned, and this time, first of all, we get my damn souls back. Don't think we got that many, but it's all we have right now. We had butter all. It's all we have right now, so you know it means a lot to me. Plus, I feel like if you die and retrieve your souls, it's not a real death, you know? But if you die twice and don't get them back, that's a real death, because then you've actually lost something, so... Yeah, and speaking of which, like, I really don't know how it's gonna work with humanity, because, you had humanity that you could lose in the last game that was up in the top left, and that got lost along with your souls if you didn't retrieve it, but, doesn't seem- Oh, God! That really freaking hurts! Doesn't seem to work like that in this game, so I'm not entirely sure how the hell that's gonna work. Maybe there is nothing like that you lose beyond souls? I don't know, man, but, yeah, I guess souls are more valuable in this, because... I don't know. Probably because we're more likely to lose them, I suppose. Right, I think we got this guy. Just take your damn time. Keep doing that three-hit combo. Good work. Now die. Thank you. Okay, one down, probably a gazillion to go. A drop? No. You freeloading son of a bitch. And did we really only get 400 souls from that? That seems terrible. Like, really, really bad considering. Oh, God. Okay, this guy's already way scarier than the last guy. He's way quicker. And I don't like the look of that giant mace thing. I feel like that's gonna hit me harder, but, maybe I'm wrong about that. I don't really want to find out. Looks like we might be able to cheese him on the side of the stairs, though. No. Okay, I rolled way too early there and somehow still got away with it. There's so much blood around here. Like, so much freaking blood. That really doesn't bode well. It's going okay so far, though. He's over half dead. Just take your time. That's not taking time. Oh, holy shit. No. Okay, again, I feel like I got really lucky there. I should probably use my assist. No. Yeah, should have used my Estus, but we're still alive. That's what matters. Now, don't kill me. No. That's a very bad giant, buddy. Okay, we can get him. Two more shots. Or one charge attack. There we go, and we got a drop. Yoink, what do we get? Sublime Bone Dust. Bone Dust is ready. Okay, what the hell does that do? Why do I have a cracked red eye up on the bar? I have a lot of junk on the bar. I guess it goes there automatically. Don't really know. Cast him into the fire, far fiery medulla. To increase the HP restored with each of you, really? So that's basically what a Bonfire Keeper Soul did in the first game. But I got that from a regular enemy. Is that a rare drop or something? Did I get lucky? I have no freaking idea, but whatever, I'll take it. We got another human FG and the Soul of a Lost Undead. Fantastic. And there's another guy there. Well, shit. I guess we may as well keep going, but we can't die at this damn rate, but hey, whatever. Okay, the core looks safe, but I don't trust this guy. He seems to have the same weapon set up as the first one, which, frankly, is kind of relieving, because the second one scared me way more, but, there's also a lot of places here I can fall off, and we all know how bad I am with gravity, considering that's how I died to these guys in the holy shit! That's how I died to these guys in the first place. Okay, we're almost back at full HP. We're gonna be fine here. Come on, buddy. Come on. Here we go. Oh, shit. Okay, take your time. Don't run out of stamina. That's running out of stamina, but that's okay. Shit! That's not okay. Got very lucky there. 115 damage. Suck on that. Okay. Just be careful, for Christ's sakes. It's not being careful, but some... What the hell? I don't know what's up with the lock-on, but whenever you do, like, a rolling attack, you always go in the opposite damn direction. And apparently when they have their shields up, they take way less damage. Okay, we're gonna go for a plunging attack here, but this is gonna be a really bad idea. I know it. Shit. Okay, we missed him, and we got away. That's what matters. Jump attack! Get out of here, you son of a bitch. I guess he was trapped there. Hey, we got another drop. A Power Stone. Don't know what all that does. I guess we'll try and check it out. But anyway, yeah, it seemed like he got trapped there because he was trying to go back to his previous spot because he was kind of out of his bounds, but, because of the staircase, his AI kind of derped out. And that works for me. I don't know where the hell the Power Stone is. Am I missing it somewhere? Surely it's an item. I don't see it. Whatever. No, God. Excuse me, I just sneezed. Hopefully I remember to cut that out, because I've been told I have a girly sneeze, which is frankly extremely offensive, because, I saw something there. Anyway, a friend of mine was on the phone to his girlfriend. You know, she was the jealous type, and I sneezed whilst he was on the phone to her, and she was like, "Who's that?" sneezing in the background. I was like, "A friend of mine." And she's like, "Is it a girl?" She was like, "Oh, he's got a girly sneeze." Like, you know, I think she thought he was cheating on her, which he wasn't, by the way. What the hell did... Oh. Okay, I just raised a ring with that.
I don't know what's happening.
Okay, whatever. I guess that was a good thing. But yeah, so, she thought he was cheating on her, and apparently I have a girly sneeze, so she thought I was the girl. And I assure you, I never had sexual relations with that man. And I never, never will. And there's three dudes in here. This is not gonna go well, is it? Can I let them out? No, I can't. Well, shit. Okay, so, we're gonna run the hell away, and we're gonna hope that, we can get them come out one at a time. It actually looks like the other two have given up, but I don't want to stand here because this guy's got a giant freaking sword and we could easily go off the edge, probably by my own doing, judging by last time. Come on, buddy. Okay, we're going to find him over here. Thank you. Now, can I take the other two at the same time? Maybe, but probably... Oh, God. Maybe, but probably not, so we might be... Oh, jeez. We might be better off running past them, or maybe we can lure them out one at a time again. I guess we'll try that. But for now, we're going to worry about killing this guy because... This giant freaking sword is scary. Why am I so bad at it? I hate myself. Okay, time to run back again. God damn it. Yoink. Okay, got my souls now. Let's get the balls out of here. Let's just use the bone because I don't want to fight these dudes. And no, use the bone. Okay, now I'm guessing, yeah, this is going to take a long freaking time, isn't it? Because, took a long damn time to use Estus. Okay, so note to self, you cannot bone anywhere near as quick as you can. Sounds dirty. You cannot bone anywhere near as quick as you could in the first game. Kind of what I expected. But either way, we got out, we got our souls. We aren't going back there right now, but we did okay, and we got something that we can use to upgrade our Estus. But I don't know how to do it, and that's not the right button. That's light the torch for no damn reason. Right, let's get rid of that. No, wait a minute. We can set the bonfire, can't we, and burn stuff. There we go. Okay, so cast into the fire and increase your HP of your Estus Flask. Nice. Okay, well, yeah, screw it, we'll do that. I don't think we need to reserve them for anything else, but you never know. Maybe it's got more than one use. I honestly don't have a damn clue. All I know is now we've got two Estus Flasks and they restore more HP. That's something. Right, now we'll check out this path down here, because I'm pretty damn sure it's the only other way we can go, and if it's not, again, I haven't found anywhere else, because I'm kind of lost. And I just noticed my HP is... Hey, we got a chest. I just know my... I just noticed my HP is terrible. Just terrible. So we may want to think about using human effigy fairly soon. Because, yeah, hey, we got a rusted coin. Don't know what the hell that does. But, you know, if you look at our HP, we're down probably a quarter, maybe a little bit more, so... That's really rather concerning. Now, as I mentioned, I'm pretty sure if you use a human effigy, it restores you back to full HP. But we only have a few, so I don't want to waste them, but... We're kind of getting to that point now where it might be a good idea, because we've already lost quite a chunk, so I think maybe in one or two more deaths we should probably use one, even though I don't want to waste them, but, you know, if it keeps us alive, then it ain't waste. This is the slowest gate ever. Holy shit. And I don't see any enemies. Okay, now, is this an illusory wall? Because, it's very suspicious to me. Now, a few people have mentioned that you can attack some illusory walls, but some are different. Some you have to use the action button, which I think is the A button on the Xbox controller, so... I was mashing the A button there, nothing happened, I also hit it, so it doesn't look like it's an illusory wall, but maybe it is, and maybe I screwed it up, I really don't know, but, holy shit, really? This gate is so damn slow, and I can't believe it shuts as well, it's really frustrating. Okay, now be careful, tight corridors means we're probably gonna get ambushed. Or, you know, we'll arrive in a cave. Okay, this is kind of cool. It's strange to me because, again, so far there have been quite a few sections like this where we haven't really run into many enemies. Now, there were places like that in Dark Souls 1, but, you know, you'd think by the point of being in this cave we'd be ambushed by something, which is why I'm kind of worried about moving around corners because, you know, something is going to happen at some point. It's just a question of when. Okay, careful. Right, we get a chest. It's not a mimic by the looks of things. Oh, we can break it. Okay, and we get rubbish. Garbage day! Right, let's go get this. Shit! Apparently, it was a ring of deep water around there. You dicks from software, you absolute dicks. Seriously, everywhere else was safe, but that little tiny ring. You got me good. I gotta say, that got me good. Okay, well, I guess I'm running back again, and damn it, I gotta go through that slow gate. Son of a bitch. Dicks, man. Freaking dicks. Okay, we got our stuff back, and there's some booty over there, but it looks to me like we're probably supposed to get that from the other side, because maybe we can run and jump from that platform, because I did try and roll, which, in retrospect, it was a really bad idea, but it looks to me like we're supposed to go around the other way, so we're going to assume that's what we do, and just get the balls out of here. And we're in some kind of forest, and I see that guy over there. Oh, Forest of the Fallen Giants. Okay, and there's a pathway that goes up here. Now, I'm worried the stream's gonna be deep water. It doesn't look like it's... But I'm worried. But screw it, it's going anyway. Okay, we're fine. Thank you. Right, so I am gonna assume here that if we go up this way, this will take us around to the back of the secret booty. And then we don't have to die in the deep water like a moron. Okay, no one's following me. Thank Christ. Okay, and there we go. What do we get? Home with Bone and a Soul of a Lost Undead. Was that worth it? No. No, it was not. Can we not get up here? No, apparently not. That's one thing I have noticed they've done quite a bit in this game, at least so far. There's invisible walls here and there. I mean, it's fair enough. It makes sense most of the time. Unlike, you know, Fallout New Vegas, for example, where they stuck invisible walls literally everywhere. Like, if you go over a little tiny hill in that game, there will be an invisible wall for no damn reason. It pissed me off. But, yeah, I don't really mind invisible walls as long as they make sense. But it's one of those things they didn't really ever do in the first game. And if they did, I don't remember it. But, yeah, like I say, I don't really mind it that much. I know some people absolutely hate any invisible wall ever, but as long as it makes sense and it's not in a really stupid place, I'm okay with that. Right, we have more booty here, and I see another dude right there. We got a life gem. Nice, and there's blood everywhere, which is really concerning to me. Wait, where'd he go? Oh, there he is. He matched him with the water. You sneaky son of a bitch. Okay, there's another guy coming, and there's an archer there. Well, shit, I guess we'll deal with this guy first. Hey, and now it's your turn. Jump attack! Oh shit, well we can take him out and then can we get out of there before- Oh damn it! I knew that was gonna happen! God, that sucks! Well, we lost a bit more HP. Maybe we should heal, but we'll hold on a little bit for now. But we do have the archer deal. You know what, screw it, we'll use our life gem now. I was gonna say, I value life gems less than Estus, which... I mean, I guess I kinda do, but now I'm thinking about it, I'm like, why do I value them less? Cause they're consumables, which, yeah, admittedly we can get them as drops and stuff like that, but yeah, now I'm thinking about it, life gems actually work a little bit quicker. They seem to restore more HP, albeit a little bit slower, but it takes a long time to chug an Estus, so... Yeah, I get a feeling the life gems are actually probably more valuable, so that might have been a bad call. What the hell? I'm taking so much freaking damage! Jesus! You archer son of a bitch! So yeah, we should probably go with the Estus more, but yeah, it probably doesn't matter that much in the grand scheme of things until we start getting to a boss fight. I can't be because I don't have any life gems. Then I'll regret it. Right, what do we get? Hollow infantry gloves. I'm guessing they're gonna be complete garbage, but whatever, we'll check them out anyway, just in case. This is the wrong menu. God damn it, brain. Pay attention. Right, there they are, and they are shit. Yeah, we'll just stick more with what we have. Plus, we look freaking awesome. Let's be honest here. Okay, we have a ladder. Is there anything else around here? Doesn't seem to be. I'm always worried when I go up a ladder, because there's nothing you can do on the damn thing. And I feel like something's gonna attack me. There is a big fella over there by a tree and a whole bunch of these hollow guys. Shit, we're in trouble. Hopefully the big guy's a friendly NPC and isn't gonna attack me. I don't think he's coming at me, but he might be one of those that wakes up when you get close or something. Holy shit, I'm nearly dead. Okay, someone arched me and I'm pretty sure he's on the wall somewhere, so... Yeah, seems to be up and left, so... Are you... Can I talk to you? No? No good! Okay, you scared the crap out of me! Don't do that! No, get away from him. I don't want to hit him by mistake. Come here, buddy. Come on, buddy. There we go. And die. Thank you. Holy shit, right. Where the hell is this damn archer? I don't know. Oh, he's there. Okay! Note to self, don't stand on the other side of the tree. And we get a broken straight sword. Great. Right, let's loot this damn thing. We get a human effigy. Nice. Right, there's a fog gate now. I'm guessing that's going to be our first boss. Maybe, maybe not. I have no idea. And we got a life gem. Okay, that's a good freaking haul there. Right, so, can we actually talk to this guy? Because it wouldn't let me do it before. No. Okay. Now, I'm assuming we can probably attack that guy. I mean, you can attack just about everyone in Dark Souls. As far as I know, and I don't see it to be any different in this game, so... We should probably not do that, because I assume he's a friendly NPC, but... Maybe he's asleep or something? I don't know. He's a dick either way. Aha, we found a ladder. So, I assume this is the way we get to the archer. Now, I'm assuming that fog gate that we saw is the boss. Maybe I'm wrong about that, but if it is the boss, I feel like the archer can probably see into that section. So, my assumption is, and this is just an assumption, but I'm assuming if there is the boss fight, the archer can probably see us and arch us whilst we're fighting the boss. So, we are probably going to... Oh, hello there, buddy. Or buddies. We are probably going to want to take out the archer before we go and do that. Now, maybe it's not the boss. Maybe I'm wasting my time, but either way, you got to figure it might at least make it a little bit less dangerous around here. Plus, we should get some booty in the process. Like that. And you never know, we might find some kind of amazing weapon or shield or armor or something up here. We might find jack shit, but if you don't try, you're never gonna know. Right, so it looks like we can go around here. Yes, we can, and we did indeed find some booty. What do we get? Damn it, I keep doing that. I keep clicking on things way too quickly. I've really gotta get used to that. Pretty sure it said Soul of a Nameless Soldier anyway. Now, I assume if we drop down here... Oh, dear God! Okay, we're fine. Wait a minute, what the hell's that? Is this not where we just came from? Yes. Okay. Anyway, so I assume this is how we get to the archer. Yes, it is. And looking at him, it looks like he probably couldn't see over that wall, but it was a precaution just in case. Plus, there's booty over there. And again, you never know, it might be amazing. Either way, we now don't have to worry about the guy. And I'm thinking maybe if we kill all the enemies in the area, then maybe that guy will talk to us. I ain't got a clue. Right, what do we get? Short sword and a soul of a lost undead. Now, the short swords are kind of crappy in the first game, so I'm assuming what we have is already going to be better, so not going to really dick around with that right now. I'll check it out more later off-screen at the bonfire, and I'll kind of examine shit, but you don't really want to see that on camera, because that'll be very boring. I assume this is how we get down safely. Yes, okay. Now, I'm assuming... Oh, God, where the hell did you come from? Like, genuine question, did you climb out of the ground or something? You sneaky son of a bitch. We got hollow infantry armor. Now, I'm assuming that's crap like the gauntlets. Okay, now we've killed all the enemies, does this guy want to talk to me? Now, what a dick. Beware of tough enemy. Yeah, in other words, don't attack that guy. Now, maybe we get something amazing for killing him, it seems possible, but we ain't doing that shit right now. We are gonna go take on the boss, assuming this is one. It's not yet. Really? Okay, so apparently it's not a boss. Now, I was led to believe the first boss wasn't that far in the game. I mean, don't get me wrong, I realize I suck and I'm taking my time here, but like, damn, what the hell is this guy doing? Get out of here! I realize I'm taking my time, but damn, I cannot believe we haven't even found one yet. This is freaking insane. I mean, I'm not good at the game by any stretch of the imagination, I'm well aware of that. But I didn't think I was going that slow. Like, holy shit! Okay, that looks like a trap there, so we gotta try and go around this way just in case. And there's a guy at the end of the hall there. And that's kind of concerning to me, and I see that doorway on the right. Now, maybe that doorway leads to that room we were just looking at, it seems possible, but, yeah, either way, I kind of would rather go around this way than the other way. Can I throw this throne up? Oh, God! Nice try, nice freaking try, you actually almost got me there, even though I knew that was probably gonna have dudes in it, because it was bound to, plus I think that was the room we just looked into. Yeah, certainly looks that way. Was not expecting two of them, though. I see you there. What do we get? Give me something good. We had wooden bolts, or at least some wooden bolts. I think it was one, I'm not entirely sure. Something. Yes. Yes. Okay, let's go take on this guy now. We gotta try and throw a knife in. Well, maybe we shouldn't, because I was gonna try and lure him out, but it looks fairly safe around here. I still kind of want to see what it does, though, but ain't gonna give me no chances, eh? Well, then you can die, you son of a bitch. Now, he looks more like a knight. Oh, God. He looks more like a knight than the other guys. Holy shit. Okay, that's not good. Run. Just run. We're gonna go in here because this might give me a chance to heal. I don't have the healing things on the bar. Okay, I do. Quick. We're gonna be fine. We're gonna be just fine. Holy shit. Anyway, I was gonna say that guy looks more like a knight than the other dudes, and yes, indeed, he nearly killed me. But point is, I'm alive, he's dead. Screw that guy. Okay, got some of the junk off the bar because, yeah, that very nearly got me killed. I want to keep the gold pyre risen there because I hold out hope that we are near the first boss and. You know, going by Dark Souls 1 logic, they gave you gold pyre resin before a boss that was weak to it, in fact, before two of them, so I'm assuming when we ran into the boss, he's probably going to be weak to it, so I want to have it at the ready, because I don't know when we're actually going to run into the guy. This seems like a good opportunity to actually use the throwing knives, which typically I just took off the goddamn bar. And, boom! Holy shit, that did a lot of damage! Okay, so note to self, throwing knives are considerably better in this game. I like that. Can we get in with another one? No, we can't. What the hell was that? Okay, we don't want him to do that to us. Yay! No. Okay, he's down. Thank Christ for that. I assume that was just a firebomb that he used, but yeah, since we don't know that, we have to worry about getting hit by that. Plus, firebombs kind of freaking hurt, so either way, we don't want that guy to hit us with that. Right, now, I see a guy there. You sneaky son of a bitch. Right, is it lighter there? It's probably where it was supposed to go, but I'm guessing there's gonna be something over here, considering there's a dude just waiting there in ambush. Yes, there's an item. What's up, buddy? Okay, I was worried he was like a friendly NPC because he wasn't doing anything, but no, he's like the worst ambusher of all time. Right, what do we get? A buckler. Okay, so if I remember from the first game, that's better for parrying. The question is it just generally a better shield than what we have already? Yeah, well, generally speaking, it seems to be better, so yeah, screw it, we'll equip that way to heal nuts. Yeah, that's why not, because apparently we don't have the stats to wield it. We'll just keep on the... What the hell is it called? The Crimson something. Crimson V? I think it was a V in there. You know what I mean. The Crimson freaking shield. Right, let's go up here, and hopefully we are near a bonfire, because if we are near the boss, then we have to run all this way again if we die, which we probably will, and that scares the crap out of me. So, Yeah, in some ways I hope we... Oh, shit. Are you ready? God damn it. So the boss is gonna be in there. Anyway, so yeah, in some ways I hope we're near the boss, but... Give me a bonfire any freaking day. Hey, buddy, you, No, you are not friendly. Well, then die. That's one thing I'm really trying to be careful of here, because... You know, there are undead merchants, at least in the first game. We got witching urns, apparently. Don't know what the hell they do. There are, undead merchants in the first game, so you never know, I could run up on one and think it's just a zombie or something, and then just kill it. Okay, so apparently the witching urns inflict magic damage. I assume they're kind of like a magic version of firebombs, but who freaking knows? Anyway, it's time to go in this damn door. I'm scared. I'm very scared right now. Oh my god, there's a bonfire. Thank you, Jesus. What the hell is that? Is that... Oh, it's like a peddler. Oh, okay. Anyway, seems like a good place to end it here. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, I always appreciate a like. And I'll see you next time for more Dark Souls 2.